Hello viewers, you are watching my YouTube channel Explore World with Pakiza. In my this video, I will cover two very important questions for foreigners visiting or living in mainland China. Mainland China does not include Macau, Hong Kong and Mongolia. The questions are, how can you exchange the currencies here in China? And what are legitimate means of transferring money to and from other countries? So coming to my first question, how can you exchange currencies in China? In China, the government has very strict control over currency exchange, and the services agencies such as banks, Western Union and Moneygram, which are responsible for the money transfer outside the mainland. That's why when someone travels or moves to China, he or she does not literally get an idea how to cope with this challenge. So if you are visiting China for a few days, I would suggest you to bring US dollars or euros that can be exchanged from any bank in your surroundings. Here you can only get your foreign currency converted from the banks only. Seemingly, there will be no limit on the foreign currency transfer to the Chinese one. However, if you need to get your Chinese currency, which is known as RMB or Chinese Yuan, converted to some other foreign currency, a foreigner can only get it equivalent to 500 US dollars in one day. If you go to some other bank to get another 500 US dollars, they are more likely to know from their central banking system that this person with specific ID has already received 500 US dollars from another bank. So you may be in a very embarrassing situation if you try to do it. If you need to stay in China for business, doing job or to study, you can get your account open in any well-known bank in China. The Bank of China, Industrial and Commercial Bank of China are the largest banking networks. Agricultural Bank of China and Postal Savings Banks of China are also considered as good banks. You may find some branches of ICBC and Bank of China in some other countries as well. So if you have their branches in your native towns, the money transfer may become convenient for you. Now I am going to address my next question. What are the legitimate means of transferring money to and from other countries? If you have RMBs and you want to send it outside the mainland, then you cannot send more than 500 US dollars by any legitimate means, because this is the condition that is imposed by a Chinese central bank that basically controls all the financial matters. If you have gathered, let's say, 1500 US dollars after going to an authorized bank for 3 days, you may be able to send it to some other country at once according to rules of that country. For example, State Bank of Pakistan allows only one person to receive up to 3000 US dollars in one day, and if the amount exceeds $3000, then that person will need to have permission from the state bank in order to receive that money. There is another interesting fact about it. If you just walk into an authorized bank of Bank of China, ICBC or PSBC to get 500 US dollars, you may be asked to come after taking an appointment first, to come another day to get 500 US dollars in cash. So there can be another possibility. If you have your account in that bank, you can get 500 US dollars in your bank account, but they will not hand over it to you in cash. Rather, you will have it in your account and you can collect it the next day after taking an appointment. Sometimes the bank policies are so rigid that they will only give you an appointment to collect your US dollars in cash if you tell them before 12 p.m. And if you inform them after 12 p.m. that day, They most probably will ask you to come after 2 days. So we can say all the banks have their own limits to hand over US dollars in cash to their foreigner customers. ICBC can give you up to 5,000 US dollars in cash in 1 day, even if you have 10,000 US dollars in your account. And the same way, PSBC will give you 10,000 US dollars in cash in 1 day. So you need to check from the bank to see its limit. There is another option that can be used by most of the foreigners if they want to send more than 500 US dollars from Chinese bank account to another bank account in some other country. For this, you have to present few documents to Chinese bank, which includes your contract, your salary slips, your income tax record, and all of these documents need to be verified by the finance office of your company. Now let's come to the point of currency transfer through Western Union. Here in mainland China, only few banks are authorized to do business with Western Union or Moneygram. I will explain the whole process here. You will not find a Western Union agent in the mainland just like you do in other territories. Probably the most largest network here for Western Union business is with China Postal Savings Bank. If you are in smaller city, then you may have only say one or two authorized branches of PSBC to help you send your money to your loved ones. If you live in Beijing, Shanghai, Guangzhou or Shenzhen, you may find most of the branches ready to do it for you. You can go to an authorized bank of PSBC with your passport and PSBC bank card. If you don't have your PSBC bank card, they will instantly open a new account for you first. If you have more than 500 US dollars in cash with you, then you can send that money to other country after paying small amount as Western Union fee. And if you have RMBs with you, you can send only 500 US dollars then. If you have gathered more US dollars in your PSBC account, you can ask the bank representative to send that amount without getting US dollars in cash. First, you may also transfer a limited amount to other foreign bank accounts using an online channel like PayPal, but definitely that will incur large amount of fee. I hope you will find this content very informative and meaningful. If you have any question about this, please feel free to ask by commenting below, and I will try my level best to respond it positively as soon as possible. Do like and share this video so that other people may also get benefits from this. Do subscribe my channel and press the bell button for more videos of China.